that sometimes in life, amen, it might not be your car that need roadside assistance. Sometimes it's you. Am I right about it? Have you ever been busted and disgusted and you are on life's road and you get stuck? Woo! I don't know about you, but it's been many times I thought I was about to do this thing. It's been many times that I was on a mission about ready to get from point A to point B. And by the time I was close to point B, something in my life broke down. About this. See, the thing about it is, I don't care if you're working Ford or if you're washing cars. Help me, somebody. I don't care if you're a billionaire, come on, Donald Trump, amen, with a squirrel on his head, or if you're somebody, come on, in the slums of the ghetto, come on, somebody barreling, making ends meet. Everybody on the face of this earth got a need. Can we say need? Well, I ain't gonna help you preach yourself in here, but I'm here to tell you, baby, ain't no sense in being jealous. Cause everything that glitters ain't gold, baby. Honey, let me tell you this. Every single person ain't lonely, and every married person ain't happy. So ain't no sense in being jealous of nobody, cause everybody got a need. Let me hit you like this. Babies have a need. Seems like they came out, they shouldn't need nothing. But babies need milk. Toddlers, let me tell you what toddlers need. People who Zaya's age, Zaya needs attention.
That's
amen. All toddlers, my boys in the back, they need attention. Come on, you gotta teach them. Come on. A, B, C, D. They need that attention. Come on, help me somebody. And then a man, I'm gonna tell you what a man needs. Everything boils down to a man needs support. I wish I had a witness up here. And let me tell you what a sister needs. Because I ain't gonna let y'all escape. What sisters needs is appreciation. I don't care what you do. It's appreciation is better than a new gold necklace. Appreciation is better than a dinner. Come on, somebody. Appreciation is better than a Christmas gift. Baby, skip Christmas. Just tell me you appreciate what I do. And that's good enough for me. Come on, help me, somebody. You can have a man who ain't got nothing, baby. But if he appreciates you, you say, I can work with him. With a brother who got some appreciation, and you ain't gonna keep on taking me for granted. Come on, help me, y'all. Teenagers need instruction. This is a dangerous thing when parents say, well, I just don't let them just do what they want to do because they got their own. No, they need instruction. If they do, you do not give them instruction, it's your fault when they fail, because you are designed to give them instruction as a child. Preachers need to study. The worst thing, it's for somebody to get up and don't know what you're talking about. You know what I'm saying? I remember having a zeal, but it wasn't according to godliness. When I was young, I couldn't wait to preach. I just felt like everybody should let me preach. But what I realized is that God knew I wasn't ready. God knew that I was all about showboat. When you're young, you're showboat. I wish I had a witness up in here. You know what I'm saying? When you see somebody who's young and they play ball and they real cold, all they gonna do is gun. You know, ball back. Just showboat. You know what I'm saying? But when you get some maturity under you, you realize that it's the fundamentals that'll help you win a game. I wish I had a witness up in here. Come on, any Scottie Pippen fans in here? Back in the day, he wasn't a showboater, but he stayed up under the basket sometimes. You need somebody who knows the game. Amen. Amen. Kroger's. Amen. Kroger's is your number one grocery store in Kentucky. But I'm gonna tell you something. Kroger's wouldn't be nothing if they ain't have a customer. And let me holler back, because I'm a Kroger person, 10 for 10, amen. Come on, somebody. Come on, they could have some gravy on sale next week. I just won't tell you ahead of time. Come on, 10 for 10, amen. But a customer needs some money. Ain't no sense in me going at Kroger trying to get from 10 to 10. Come on, ain't no money on your EBT. Come on, ain't no money in your, come on, your account. And come on, stop playing. I know we got some EBT people in here. Amen. But see, ain't no sense in you going there if you ain't got no money. Amen. And even a leader, there's no great leader that don't have a follower. need. Amen. Don't be ashamed because you're in a little season where you might be going through a little something. Amen. Amen. I remember being with my friends back in the day. Amen. And back in the day, they was balling. Amen. They had so much money. And they'd be like, come on, Cokie, let's go to the mall. But Cokie couldn't go to the mall. Amen. Because it wasn't my season to go to the mall, Sean. Cokie had to pay her bills. And after I got through paying my bills, I ain't have nothing but a little chump change. And I couldn't do nothing at the mall but buy some bubble gum. I wish I had a witness up in here. But I wasn't ashamed of what I was going through because I knew that eventually the tables would turn. I knew that eventually, if I kept my trust in God, I knew that eventually, if I kept working the word of God, I knew that eventually, that God would bless the work of my hands. I knew that eventually, He'll bless me on my job. I knew that eventually, He'll bless my clothes. I knew that eventually, He'll put favor upon me. And where I was the last, God would make me the first. I wish I had a witness up in here. The Bible says that those that are last, many that are first, will be last. So ain't no sense in you being ashamed, because God got a way of changing things. He got a way of shifting things. If you keep your hands in the master's hands, God will take care of you. Come on, clap your hands up in this place. Yeah. Need crosses all boundaries. It crosses racial boundaries. Black people got needs, white people got needs. Come on, mixed people got needs. Chinese got needs, Asians got needs. I wish I had a witness up in here. It crosses racial boundaries. It crosses financial boundaries. It crosses social and political and denominational boundaries. It crosses economical boundaries. A need is a need. But I just want to let somebody know that God is keenly aware. To be keenly aware means that He is definitely aware of everything that you have need of. I wish I had a witness. Means God is not caught just because Pearl broke down over last week. God knew Pearl was going to break down. God knew what God was going to face before I faced it. God wasn't taken aback because my stuff broke down. God said that I'm going to give you some wisdom. This is what you do. You move this over here. You have to wait a little bit. Just drive with your husband right now. Be a little sleepy right now. But you got to do what you got to do. Come on. Help me somebody. God will help you navigate through situations. The Bible says, Matthew 6 and 30. Y'all gonna let me preach up in here. Lord Jesus, I'm preaching myself happy. So sometimes the devil will make you have a pity party. Baby, ain't nobody coming to your pity party but you. Don't nobody want to come to your messed up, jerked up pity party. Amen. God don't bless pity parties. Amen. Shake yourself off. Put on your strength. Put your big girl panties on and keep it moving, baby. You gotta stop crying over spilled milk. We ain't little kids no more. Life happens. Stuff happens. Trials happen. Trouble comes. Baby, but God ain't kept you this long. What would make you think He's gonna leave you now? Matthew chapter 6. I'm just gonna tell you what God said. It's in red in my Bible. Jesus said, wherefore, if God so clothed the grass of the field, the grass ain't asking to be green, it's green automatically. I wish I had a witness up in here, which is from day to day, and tomorrow is cast into the oven, and it shall no more be clothed. Oh yeah, little faith, verse 31 is where I'm going. Put 31 on the screen, baby. It says, therefore take no thought, saying, what shall I eat? Or what shall I drink? Or where shall I be clothed? Take me to the next verse, baby. Take me to 32. For after all these things do the Gentiles seek, for your heavenly Father knows what you have need of. Somebody say need. Amen. So that means even if you don't say nothing, God knows what you have need of. God see you right now. He saw you when you rolled over at 4 o'clock in the morning. I wish I had a witness. He knew you was going to yawn before you yawned. He knew when you was going to have to tinkle. Amen. God know everything about us. Amen. He know your thought before you think it. Hey, hallelujah. I wish I had a witness up in here. Take it to the next verse, baby. But God know the thing you have need of. But this is the instruction from the Holy Ghost. It said, but if you seek you first, the kingdom of God and all of His righteousness, then all of these things, what you shall eat, what you shall drink, how you gonna pay your bills, how you gonna get your car fixed, who's gonna love you, your children's situation. If you seek ye first the kingdom of God and all these things, then what you need will be added unto you. But I want to ask a question to the church this morning, because I realize that while I know that everybody in here got a need, I realize that sometimes a spirit of pride will get on people. And I just want to ask a question up in here. What happens to a person who act like they don't have a need? Know a person one time who really, really needed a blessing. And real talk, they were worthy of it. Good people. And so situation happened where the lights got turned off. But now they're not a people who are always begging, and they people who kind of fend for themselves, but they came across hard times.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Now so all of a sudden we want to go over and watch American Idol. And ain't no lights on. Okay, but see now, when I talked to my girl later on, I said, "Now you didn't have to be like it, because you are good ground. You are working. You work hard. You and your husband work hard. You just fell on hard times.
Yeah.
But because you didn't say nothing.
Yep. Come on now. Uh-huh.
Bible says you have not because you ask not. Uh-huh. Yeah. Come on, help me somebody. Now, does that mean that somebody always gonna be able to help you? No, I don't mean that. But it means that sometimes, baby, you gotta open your mouth. You